For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008 7 from your sample files folder. Most of the time, solid colours are all you need, but you might want to make data look more interesting for a PowerPoint presentation or for publication in a newsletter or a web page. When you add colours, it's usually best to stay within those of the current theme. This enables you to quickly change the appearance of the worksheet to match that of a PowerPoint presentation or Word document that might use a different theme. In this lesson, we'll add a gradient to the sharp transition between the orange totals section and the blue transaction details section of the worksheet. Instead of the sharp transition from blue to orange you can see on the borders of columns D and E, we'll create a smooth transition in column E so that you have a sort of an airbrushed effect as the colour smoothly moves from blue to orange. Before creating the transition, it's a good idea to remind myself about which colour is in the blue section and which colour is in the orange section, because I'll need to use these colours in a moment to define the transition. So I'll click anywhere in the blue section and then home on the ribbon and in the font group, the right-hand side of the fill colour split button. When I click, you can see that the colour has a red outline, and if I hover over the colour, it says blue, accent 1, lighter 80%. But I think all I really need to remember is that it's the lightest of the blue colours. If I click in the orange section and do the same thing, I can see that this is the lightest colour in the orange section. So I'll be careful to remember that as I move on to define my gradient fill. I'm going to apply the gradient fill in column D. So I'll select cells D5 to D21. Now I need to bring up the Format Cells dialog. You might remember that there's several ways to do this. One method is to right-click in the selected cell and then select Format Cells from the shortcut menu. And that's my favourite method. But you can also use the dialog launchers on several of the groups, such as the Alignment group. And this also brings up the same Format Cells dialog. Now, because I'm working with a gradient fill, I think I'll find the option I need under the Fill tab of Format Cells. And when I click the Fill tab, notice that there's a Fill Effects button. The Fill Effects button will enable me to define that gradient fill. So I'll click Fill Effects, and here's the gradient dialog. This is why I need to remember those two colours. Because for my two colour fill, I'll need to set the first colour as colour 1 and the second colour as colour 2. Now, just to demonstrate the different shading styles, I'm going to temporarily make those colours a little darker. And now let's look at the shading styles options at the bottom of the dialog. At the moment, we have a horizontal shading style. And notice that the variants are to shade from orange at the bottom to blue at the top, blue at the bottom to orange at the top, or have orange in the centre and blue at the top and the bottom. And if I click on each of these variants to select them, you can see in the sample box exactly what the result would be. Now let's look at the vertical shading style. The first style is to shade from blue on the left to orange on the right, and that's ultimately the style I'm going to choose. The next variant is blue on the right, orange on the left, and the last variant is orange in the centre and blue on both the left and right. Let's also quickly look at the diagonal up shading style, diagonal down, from corner, and from centre. So I'll select the vertical shading style, and I'll select the variant from blue on the left to orange on the right. Now let's put those colours back to their true colours. Colour 1 was the lightest blue, and colour 2 was the lightest orange. I'll now click OK and OK again, and notice that you now have a beautiful transition from the blue fill on the left to the orange fill on the right, instead of that hard transition from blue in column D to orange in column E. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Week Ended 14th of March 2008 8, and as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 410, Add Colour and Gradient Effects to Cells.